The third Kuwait Electricity and Water Conference and Exhibition kicked off with the aims of delivering high-quality energy education to various stakeholders. The conference will also offer organizations with business interests in the region to leverage the opportunity and play a major role in one of the world's fastest developing power markets. Sarah Faris Globe has more in this report.
Under the patronage of the Minister of Electricity and Water and Minister of Public Works, Abdulaziz Al-Ibrahim, the third Kuwait Electricity and Water Conference and Exhibition opened with the aim of exploring the best practices available to improve power and water networks efficiency, optimize asset performance, and reduce operation and maintenance costs.
Actually, I'm a lighting specialist. I'm a certified lighting energy professional from the Association of Energy Engineers in the United States. What I'm presenting today is my total expertise in lighting, especially with what's happening in buildings in Kuwait, office buildings. So I'm giving out like a holistic upgrade for the lighting systems in terms of quality and quantity. So I'm going to discuss the impact of retrofits, impact of just minor changes in the lighting systems and their effect on energy and also on CO2 emissions. We've been having a great cooperation with the Ministry of Electricity and Water since the 1980s, actually, since we started the energy building code in 1983, which became a policy in Kuwait for saving energy, and Kuwait became the first country in the Middle East to apply this energy code. And since then, we've been cooperating with the Ministry of Electricity and Water in saving energy, finding new technologies and trying to apply new technologies, energy auditing, operations of buildings.
The two-day conference focused on four areas, including energy conservation, water, policy and regulations, and technology and innovation.
I will be covering the LED lights, the type of LED lights, indoor and outdoors, and also I'll be talking about what type of electricity saving. I have certain calculations. I mean, if you use the LED light for like street lighting, if you use it for indoors, how much you can save. And also, what are the environmental? It's much more detailed analysis and calculation with the fills cost. You know, I mean, with the whole cost of electricity rate in Kuwait, and shows you, you know, if you use our type of lights or LED lights in general compared to the conventional light, what are the savings? Also, we will talk about all the benefits. It's our idea to start this company as the first and the only specialized company in Kuwait in LED, because we think this is the trend, and also this is what Kuwait needs, because Kuwait, now we have the highest per capita consumption of electricity.
Kuwait is set to dramatically increase the country's power capacity to 17,500 megawatts by 2014, up from the current capacity of 12,000 megawatts. The world's fourth largest oil exporter is looking at meeting growing energy demands, and the expansion of the country's electricity grid is part of a larger four-year development plan worth over $106 billion.
The ministries in Kuwait have traditionally been very conservative in their adapting of new technologies. And this is a huge step forward for the ministries to embrace the new technologies, to look at different ways of applying some of the projects that they have for the future. With the addition of the new private power facilities that will come in Kuwait, there needs to be a step change in the ministries, and I think this is a long way towards that step change.
As the government plans to expand Kuwait by that much in a limited amount of time, then the ministries need to continue efforts such as this conference in order to find sustainable and economic methods. However, the public also has a role, as conservation is a social responsibility. From the Radisson Blu Hotel in Kuwait, this is Sarah Glubb reporting for English News.